Rainbow robot.
So the next thing I'm going to work on is building a reactor. This is going to take quite a while, but one thing I'm definitely going to need is a whole lot of alloys, so I am going to start making those alloys. Another thing that I'm going to need is a lot of energy tablets. So I'm going to need to set up some system for crafting them so that I don't have to craft them myself. I think I want that to be here. And I think I've got what I need to make it on me.
So when I got close to it, furious zombies started coming out.
Yeah, that might happen.
And I murdered their faces, and now everything is quiet again.
Okay. Well, so far so good. You might discover that furious zombies is all that happens at that particular one. Some of them, I think, do it more than others. Okay, I have myself an auto workbench, which I will place... here, I guess. Yeah. And then I need a chest. For them to go into. There we go. And then I need a pipe. Logistical transporter, there we go. I have a lot of them, because I just dismantled the carrot pipeline, which was made of them. So we put one there. Configure it to take out of the crafting of the auto workbench. Good. Now it's going to need some gold in there, and it's going to need some redstone. Hey, we have 18 compressed redstone. Let's throw that in the metallurgic infuser. There we go. That is a lot of redstone. We're going to be making a lot of alloys. I guess we'll just start feeding the iron into it.
This one is definitely the right biome. The sky turned the same color.
Yep.
But there's nothing in it except for a couple of ferns that are black.
I don't know. Maybe there's something underground. Might not be worth searching for.
Yeah, I was going to go to the other one since there's two nearby.
Okay, so I'm looking for gold. We've got quite a bit of gold. That's good. Probably going to to have to cast some more, though. I'm done with
this
the iron,
that is. The purple platform and the node, but no pillar hovering above it.
Yep. That is, I believe, the other arrangement. Is the platform like a trapezoid, or is it a cube?
It's a cube with a hole in the middle and all the corners missing.
Hole in the middle and all the corners missing. I'm not sure what that means.
The hole in the middle is 3 cubes deep. Well, it doesn't have the caps either, or the base, or the hovering.
But it does have a square of obsidian?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is a square of obsidian and eldritch whatever.
Okay, that's it's got pretty much the whole shebang. It doesn't have the actual pillar, but everything else it has. Possible somebody harvested the pillar. They're kind of decorative, I suppose. So we should have some alloys in here now. Yep, we have some. So we'll go ahead and put them in the crafting table here and see if it starts producing energy tablets. Oh, sorry, we need to include them in the recipe, too. Okay, there we go. There's a recipe. It looks like it's going to produce them. Let's see what we get here. Looks like it made one. And it went into the chest. Excellent. So we now have an energy tablet-producing device. The other thing we want to do is start saving brine. Because we're going to need brine to make lithium, which we'll need to make tritium, which is one of the two fuels that the reactor needs to run. Now, this is a fusion reactor, which means that the stuff it runs on is considerably cheaper than a fission reactor, like the big reactor that we've been using. So, I believe we take a couple of these quintuple compressed cobblestone, and these quadruple compressed cobblestone. That hopefully will be enough to make a bedrockium drum. Because we're just going to save all of the extra brine for an entire week. And that is liable to take more than just a regular drum. Also going to Okay, back in the Twilight Forest with our compressed cobblestone. Now we don't need any quintuple, so I'll just turn it all into quadruple. Now we're going to need, what is it, 6 times 4, 24 quadruple compressed cobblestone. So the rest of this is going to be triple. Okay, and hopefully that's what we'll need. We're going to need 6 diamond blocks, I believe. Have those, good. And with that, we should be able to make bedrockium. There we go, bedrockium. 6 of them. So we've got 6 bedrockium ingots, and then we need a cauldron and 2 gold pressure plates. Then we should be able to make a bedrockium drum. Excellent. So I wasn't thinking necessarily that this would be something that you want to spend all your time doing. It's just that I thought that if you knew that there were nodes underneath those, then you could recharge your wand at those nodes. And while you're doing that, you might happen to run across an Eldritch Guardian.
Okay.
So, I mean, don't feel like you, you know, need to suspend your researches into Thaumcraft to do this.
Well, I'd kind of come to a stopping point anyway. I'm not really sure what my next goal ought to be.
Well, have you looked through your Thaumonomicon to just see, you know, if anything's particularly interesting, or...? So this is gaseous brine, is that correct? No, this ought to be liquid brine. Yeah, it's going into the liquid side. Now, the water thing is quite close to it here. But I don't think it will connect. Hello? There we go. To the side of a drum. Now, let's see. It might screw everything up. It did, but it didn't go in. Okay, so that's the important thing. And then if we do this, and then set this to output. There we go. Okay, now all of the brine is going through the spedrachium drum, and any excess brine will be stored in it rather than just back up in the system. So the next thing we want to do is heavy water. To do that, we're going to need a pump and a filter. Spare pumps in here, and it has to be a mechanism pump, not a BuildCraft pump. There's the mechanism pump, electric pump, which needs a bucket, a steel casing, 2 enriched alloy, and 3 osmium ingots. First we make the steel casing, there we go, and then we should be able to make the electric pump itself. Yes. Okay, we also need a filter. Filter upgrade for mechanism, that's it, which requires 2 enriched alloy, tin dust, and 2 pieces of glass.
I guess I have a couple of nodes I was thinking I would put in jars and move around.
Have you figured out what to do with nodes in a jar? Can you recharge your wand using them? I think you can, I just don't remember how.
Yeah. Oh, but to do that you need a wand that's capable of holding a charge of 70. And I top out at 50.
So I was getting some tin dust. Do I happen to have any tin dust in here? Aluminum dust, silver dust, iron dust, steel dust. Looks like I do not have any tin dust, so I'm going to need to make some. Now what is this? A block of tin. Well, that's convenient. Coincidental and convenient. So we need to crush this tin. Thank you. That was all I needed. Okay. 2 enriched alloy, 2 glass. 10 dust. Makes a filter upgrade. Excellent. So we've got an electric pump and a filter upgrade. So we're probably going to need some mechanical pipe for this task. There we go. Two basic universal cable. Hopefully that will be enough to allow us to set this up. So already at this base, we have stuff producing oxygen for us as part of this complicated process. And in order to do that, it's this thing here. And it is splitting water into hydrogen and oxygen. But we might as well just be feeding in heavy water. Why not? Because it also has oxygen. So let's see how we're going to do this. We want to unhook this pump from the electrolytic separator. Like so. And hook it up instead directly to the pipe that goes to the other stuff that needs water. There we go. Unfortunately, it's also still going into the electrolytic separator via the back, huh? Yes, okay. Now it does not connect. There we go. That was a lot easier than it could have been. In fact, these other spurious connections here can probably also be removed. I think some brine accidentally went in the system, though. I don't know where it went, though. There we go. Is it still actually producing water? Nope. I managed to screw it up somehow that time. I think if I break and replace the solar evaporation controller, that will fix it. So we'll just do that quick. It'll lose us some power, unfortunately. Okay. Thank you. And replace it. Like so. Brine went into it. Okay. It's also going out of it, which is not good. I think I can just break and replace that pipe in order to stop that from happening. We need to wait for it to be processed. Okay, there we go. Now we break and replace this again. And now we're getting water again. Excellent. Okay, good. We're back to working. Yay. Okay, so now we need to set up this pump.
Ooh.
I think we might actually want to make a separate pool of water just to be safe. Buckets on me? Nope, but I can make one with this iron quite easily. Pump. There it is. It needs a filter, which goes in the upgrade slot. There we go. Now it has a filter. A filter that separates heavy water from regular water. Then we take cable, power cable, and hook it up to the power. Okay, and it should start producing heavy water. Then we pipe that water by a mechanical pipe into the electrolytic separator. Like so. Now it's not going to go in there as long as there's still water in the electrolytic separator, regular water that is. So we'll have to wait till that gets used up. It's time for us to start making gold instead, because we're going to need some gold.
I think there is something that I don't understand.
Okay.
Because I went to Ben's tutorial chamber.
Yep.
And I made sure I had scanned all the things that you need to scan to learn things.
Yep.
And yet, when I look in my... Hold on, I have to sleep real quick. When I look in my Thaumonomicon...
Uh-huh.
It tells me that if I want to do things like make a better wand, I'm missing required research.
Okay. So research is not the same thing. Research is connecting stuff on the research table.
Oh.
So you may not have followed the research tree far enough to do that thing yet. You might have other stuff you need to do first. I don't know. I'd have to look at it. Like, on your screen, because, like, I'm not in the same place in Thaumcraft that you are, because I haven't done any of it, really.
Okay.
So the next thing I need to do is charge a laser. And in order to do that, well, it's not really... I use a laser to charge something. So first I have to build a laser. A laser. And it's this kind of laser from Mekanism, which requires a diamond, 3 reinforced alloys, 2 energy tablets, and a steel casing. How am I doing for reinforced alloys? I have enough. Okay, good. 3. I'm going to be low on osmium, though, aren't I?
Doesn't tell me is where I can get knowledge fragments.
They show up in, like, chests and things. Like, if you chop down infested greatwood trees, you're liable to find knowledge fragments in the box underneath.
In the box underneath the greatwood tree?
The infested ones, you know?
But the... Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so I found 4.
Osmium, that's right. Okay. Okay. So the steel casing goes there, the diamond goes there. Reinforced alloys go there, there, and there, and energy tablets go there, and there, and we have a laser. We will also need a laser amplifier, which requires a basic energy cube, which requires 2 more energy tablets. Hello.
Hi.
First, you make the casing. There we go. Then we make. There we go. Basic energy cube. Okay. Then we need 7 steel and a diamond. So the diamond goes here, the steel goes around here, basic energy cube goes in the middle, and we have a laser amplifier. Then we still need the windmill. There we go, a wind turbine. Excellent. It's probably going to need to be quite a ways away from this setup because there's going to need to be room between it and this setup for stuff to get done. We need to place the laser amplifier. Like so, I believe? Yes. Okay, you'll notice that one side of it is black. That is good. And then we place the laser just beyond it. Yes, and the windmill to power the laser, except that we don't want to let the laser out. So we need to set it to high. That means that it will only output what it has stored when it gets a redstone signal. Now we can hook up the wind turbine. And the laser is becoming powered, and this is slowly storing energy.
Warning, warning, this video is almost over. Warning, warning, it's time to choose another one. This has gone on far too long, time to wake up and sing along. Warning, warning, this video is over now.